So I believe that we have been dealing with conflicts at the grassroots level, very serious conflicts, trying to get an equilibrium between marine conservation and also the sustainable use of these resources that bring development to a lot of people. So when the guidelines were approved, we have found a way of actually dealing in a very straightforward discussion with governments and other NGOs about the need of improving well-being of communities at the same level of actually improving the ecosystem.
Y si buscamos que cada pescador conozca las directrices, tenemos que hacerlo en sus lenguajes, en sus formas y en la mejor manera para que llegue a su conocimiento, su poder. En el caso de Costa Rica tenemos comunidades afrocaribeñas, tenemos comunidades costeras, tenemos comunidades indígenas, y todas ellas requieren formas de información diferente.
I think we still have a long way to go, but certainly the instrument, the tool of having this global agreement might bring us a very good opportunity to prove different models where communities are part of the conservation efforts of countries.